doing dialogue as the game shows on Battle Island Commanders gameplay, strategizing. First, we're going to begin with the cards. It's very similar to Magic the Gathering or Pokemon. I'm not going to go into great detail on this. I think some of these things are principally self-evident, though the basic gist is get your cards out fast, meaning choose a multitude of low value to moderate value cards and a couple of high value butt kickers. Now, originally I had in a transport, I switched it over to a tank, as you will see here, right there. Reasoning, the transport and the big tank were too hard to get out simultaneously. They could not support each other. Now, the good news is I'm going to show you this in chess principles. Well, the first thing is why chess? Well, chess breaks into three components: an opening, a middle game, and an end game. If you cannot get your opening correct, you may not get to the other parts of the game. Pretty simple. Now, I'm going to cover some points of an opening, and these points actually carry through the rest of the game, the first of which is positioning, the second of which is timing, the third of which is the value of the pieces, fourth of which is teamwork amongst the pieces. The pieces you chose should represent pieces that will work together, because you do not know what your opponents are going to put out. This is the great difference between this and chess. This is where it's more like one of the card games, where you have an enemy who has a pile of cards. They are in a position where they can put out anything. In this case, the guy's using machine gun nests. I have people who use bomber planes. I have people who've gone against me who obviously spent money and do better than me because of that. I have people who do better than me because they're just better. But we're all looking to get a little bit better. And now, these are, in some cases, some of my better gameplays from recently. We all like seeing that little victory. Why? Because the victory leads to more chests. The victory leads to more stars for more chests. So, the positions of power. Normally in chess, what you would want to see is a position that would suggest the center of the board. Why? Because when a person has to move around the flanks and only can move in that way in a chessboard, it's a little bit different here, though. You're not so constrained. For instance, your jeep could go through the center, but mainly you want to get bridges fought through. You need to get to the main gun capsules. Most people want to take one of them out, occasionally both of them. Depends on how you're feeling that day. Now, if you notice, he chose the first move. The point being is that is a first move which had no backing on it. Oh, suddenly I've got a swarm of people out, doing pretty good. I have tanks going, and everybody is moving right along the center line, as I said they should. The order in which everyone moved was pretty pertinent to that. That thing was destroyed before the opening time is out. I consider the opening the first minute. Now, technically in chess, the opening is usually considered the first 15 to 35 moves, depending on the player. There are several principles that you're going to see in play that worked superbly with this one. It's almost like they gave up, so I'm not sure what happened. They were waiting for something. Had to go to the bathroom. They're internet connection went out, all sorts of things happened, as I'm sure you've had happen to you too. 0.3 time. This is not like, well, I've only got 15 minutes kind of thing. This is who goes first, why you may choose to want to go second, why you may choose to want to go first. Typically speaking, my son Firecat wants to go second. He will wait with a full charged bar that's throbbing and ready to just explode all over the people. But in my case, time also relates to how quickly you develop your pieces. Mistakes in time can be as deadly as the other person having way better pieces than you. If you notice, within the first 2 minutes, I have this guy pretty well chewed through. Why? Lots of cheap pieces, in this case also developed pieces, and I'm able to move them out quickly. That's why I suggest the card phase, you go with low-cost cards. Lots and lots of twos. There we go. Bang. Now, I like the missile. I like the spray. Again, how much can you use? I noticed the flamethrower guy is actually a pretty good guy to have because of that little extra explosion. That is going to be a matter of what you want to do. Now, we have gotten through the time phase. If you notice, this is what the element of time gives as an advantage. He should be worried about me blowing up his ship now, where I can let him sit a little bit. Now, I'm developing on the back end here, but generally speaking, even that development is to move the time along. Yeah, bummer. Some of my side guys got killed, but hey, I've got the big pieces going. I've got the press. That's something I'm going to hit for middle game and end game. But that first development made it to where he is crushed to the back. He no longer has the center of the board. He is at the back of the board. And I've been in that position. I'm not perfect. This is just strategic and tactical thinking. This is not something you can pull off every single time, so don't feel bad if you don't. Now, we get to the next phase. This one is utterly important. It's value. What is the value of your piece? Now, in chess, your king is worth 8, your rooks are worth 5, actually the king is worth end of game, the queen is worth 7, pawns are worth 1, blah blah blah. But if you went back and saw that, here he's got his big tank for 6, he blew up my 5 tank, he's gonna blow up my 3 with something that's worth 6, my 2 killed a 6. And I'm thinking, maybe I should put a tank out. I don't know. This is just a stellar use, poor use of bad time. That plane is worth 7, and he applied 7 to bomb barbed wire and only take 100 or 2 points off of my bunker, which opened up a world of trouble for him. Now, typically speaking, I say hit the one side, hit the one side, smack the one side. I decided I would play a little on his bottom end and go for the bottom bunker as well. It sets a pattern, It sets the mood. The guy's already working in that direction. It pulls him along. It's kind of the psychology of the game. Some people go for it, some don't. I'll put my little tank out over there. And he's probably thinking he's going to chew through eventually. I don't know why he didn't do anything about that barbed wire sooner. But a little more damage to that other bunker, which, you know, sets it to where if I get two bunkers, I still get the win. So it's kind of a not bad deal there. But the value of his pieces, had he used those extra five earlier instead of on messing around with my guys, he would have probably had my pillbox down and would have been banging on the boat like I did to him. Anyway, on to the next bit. Here we come to our last installment, which I put in this teamwork. In reality, in chess, it's the interlacings of your men, or woman, depending, and how they interconnect. The interconnectedness of the pieces. Your pawns are guarded by your bishops, which may be double guarded by a knight, which may be triple guarded by another pawn. Those knights, bishops, and pawns guard one another. The rooks and or castles, depending on how you see it, guard each other. Well, in this case, he should have me beat. Part of it was I wasn't necessarily pulling the best things out. Part of it was, you know, he has a great intermixing here. He has got a jeep going through, which is leading attack. He has got a cannon, which is guarded by a machine gun nest, which already had some damage. The jeep is going. He should press his advantage. And he is. He's got a great big honking armor breaking tank out on my butt. And there's a strike. Yeah, this guy has got me, and my cards are not coming up that great. You see, we're a minute and a half into this game. He has me on time. Where did he lose? Here. These defensive cannons are not necessarily the best defense. I don't know how to explain it any better other than they get chewed up too readily. And this is where the teamwork comes out and shines. Bazooka and tank together are devastating. Having an officer help them better. Pulling in, you know, riflemen, getting through this. I'm looking at the jeep and I'm thinking, I should maybe let that go, but you know what? I'll have my team work from the back to do my defense and run to the front, because that's how they're going to work anyway. Teamwork won. The teamwork lost it in this particular match. I should have lost, but if you notice, I was able to build up a massive amount of force. And there's my bazooka guy. He's like, maybe I'll go chase after him. Yeah, never mind. I gotta get back with the team, man. Oh man, a lot of the team's dead. Oh, but here come the girls. Here comes an officer. Here comes some riflemen. Here comes a big tank, if I remember correctly. So I thought another bazooka guy in there. Oh, there's the tank. Yeah, and there's another jeep. It's like, I don't know, dude. Anyway, this is what you were waiting for. Hopefully you'll get more of it yourself. I would like to thank you for watching. My next installment. There'll be middles and endings and probably some other strategic things, but until then, goats out.